Babe knocks a stick out of Preville's hand. Rick tries to pull it away from Draper. Draper changes up and jumps on the ice and knocks Mike's stick out of his hand. Doug Brown pulls both over to the bench and Keith picks both of them up. Mike says, Keith, can I have my stick back? And Keith says, sure, Mike, let me fix it a little bit for you first. Mike says, thanks, Keith, have a drink on me. Here's another one. Warren Reichel gets a stick pulled out of his hand by Maltby. Sackey can't go back and get it because he's afraid of getting too many men on the ice penalty. Draper pulls it up to Maltby, and he throws it behind the bench. Warren says, hey, that's my goal score. The stick was never seen again, folks.
Around here, it's more than hockey town. It's home.
Red Wings residence.
Rudge.
Coach, it's for you.
Don't forget the stairs, buddy.
Now that's putting the home in home ice.
November 1st, Wings, Wild. Get the Coke Zero Family Pack starting as low as $54. Red Wings Hockey, presented by Amway.
All right, it's good to go.
Here at the Joe, we're fierce competitors on the ice and off the ice, too. Hey, we take every game seriously.
Check.
Sweet.
Here at the Joe, we like to treat our opponents with respect. We try to accommodate their needs as best we can. And make sure they're comfortable. Until the puck drops.
Game day skate at Joe Louis Arena starts very, very early in the morning, but it was hardly typical for that 19-year-old kid, a freshman at Macomb Community College earlier. Jordan's a kid who grew up playing hockey in Fraser and Berkeley and then was hit with the staggering news that he has cystic fibrosis. Some, but not all, of his hockey dreams ended with that diagnosis. He still plays rec league hockey, bouncing back after a few run-ins with every CF patient's dread, pneumonia. The Make-A-Wish people got involved to get Jordan out of the ice this morning, out of the game tonight, and he got a chance to hang with Datsyuk and Zetterberg. And the wow factor will certainly hang around for a while.
It's way, way cooler than I thought this was going to be.
So did you make the right wish?
Yeah, for sure. For sure.
Tough to top this, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Oh, it was awesome. You know, we, the first time I heard it was last year, but he, had an accident with his ankle, so he couldn't really come out and skate with us. So when we heard he was coming out this year, we were excited.
Thank you.
What's up, buddy? It's all yours.
Whoa! Whoa!
Look at, they're all ready, set to go.
I'm just taping, that's all I'm doing today.
It's a bar you want to get into, puppy.
Smooth him, tip him. Try to slip him something.
Johnny here? He's in the back. He said to come by. He's in the back. Johnny?
Hello, how are you doing, sir?
Good. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I am honored to be greeting the mighty Detroit hockey team, winners of the Stanley Cup. 3 out of the last 6 years, 10 times winners of the Stanley Cup, and the team that made Detroit hockey town. Somebody said, well, you know, the roster looks like the Hall of Fame ballot. Doesn't look like the Hall of Fame ballot to me. It looks like the United Nations.
I had the chance to meet President Clinton, two different personalities. Seems to me George W. Bush knows exactly what he's doing. He's great. He's in charge.
Darren McCarty put it this way. He said, a lot of us were fighting, when I say the word it, it's talking about the Stanley Cup. A lot of us were fighting to get it back. Some guys were fighting to do it for the first time. The bottom line is we're all fighting to do it together. And I appreciate that spirit. I think it's a good example for a lot of people who live in America.
I've had some cool stuff happen to me in my life.
It's up there.
That's right there.
Yeah.
Detroit's humble champs offer up their best winning grin. With full knowledge of the challenges that lie ahead for a team not accustomed to failure.
Where's the pucks?
Pucks are here.
Brett Hull is very competitive, wants smart plays, doesn't like dumb hockey players. You know, there's a lot of those passions that only winners have, and he has that passion.
He's a guy that hates to lose. He's very demanding of his teammates, but he's also very demanding of himself.
You know what? Everyone owns me this year. I suck. Don't feel so proud.
Hully, you gotta understand, Hully, he's just not happy unless he's bitching and moaning.
You're taking the hardest working guy's spot!
Bitching and moaning makes Hully happy.
What the hell kind of pass is that?
You know, it's not a practice unless Hully's yelling at somebody.
Where's my stick? I got no stick!
That might get you a deal with that tape company right there. Renfrew, call him.
A lot of what I say to people is for reactionary purposes. I want to see what kind of reaction I can get out of you. What, like, do you believe what I'm saying? You know, make you think a little bit. You know, is he serious? Is he not serious? You know.
It's all right. If those two young guys don't want to go back, I'll just go back.
It makes me accountable for my actions out there, because if I'm going to get on Luke, you know, I better go down and throw a good shot at the net myself, or everyone's going to jump on me. And it keeps me sharp.
Good gosh almighty! Thank God for Brett! Heads up!
Woo-hoo! You're out there with 19 other kids playing a game, having fun. It's like recess.
What do we got here?
Yeah, this one was ugly. You need these ugly practices to get all the junk out of your legs.
It's fun. I think that's the big reason why this team is successful. The guys come to the rink and have fun.
Yeah!
Look at that. 70 pounds.
Oh, yeah, Charlie!
The camera shook when you dropped it.
Compared to Red Army training, that's nothing, man. It's only two reps you did, and that's about it.
You gotta add another 11 stations.
There is 11. 14.
Especially the new dressing room. Guys like hanging around the room even a little bit more this year, so it's nice.
What'd you think of last night's episode?
Dad killed the mom. She's in the trunk with the cop.
Oh, yeah.
That was, you know, that was a little twist. No one sort of
expect. We're talking about 24. Best show on TV.
Jack Bauer.
Darren, he'll entertain you any way you want. Maybe hold a little one-on-one performance for you, the rock star.
Check, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Sometimes the guys, they give you little ribs about this, but it's nothing to be taken too seriously. It's just everybody's got to have hobbies and enjoy to do things.
I can only give you everything, but I can give you what you need.
Anybody who knows me knows that I'm not afraid to make a fool of myself, so... If that's what some people think, then that's their opinion, but I have a great time doing it.
And that's rock right there.
If you want to hear the English language in a whole different form, go talk to Thomas Holmstrom.
When I'm with you, you learn the stuff every day, you know?
I know what you're saying.
People at home, I can translate that.
Stay away from him. Make a good show. I guess that's pretty well it.
About 2 or 3 years ago, he said to me, I think I finally found something I really loved.
those things, my cars. Sergey loves his cars.
I like this car. I like the sound of it. I like the power of it. And if you guys have a, you know, time and everything, I'd like to invite you to my house. I want to show you my hyper simulator, which is play PC Formula One games.
Sergey Fedorov, I've seen him since he was a young player here, not speaking a lick of English. Extremely talented. So Stevie being out, we look to him to be our offensive leader, game in and game out.
I know for a fact, Dave told me yesterday that you're going to play against Mario. I said, that'll be great. I'm going to chase him all night. Maybe to chase me. It depends who's going to have possession of the puck. Beautiful day in Michigan. Thanks.
In this week's edition of Trug Takes On, we've evened the playing field a little bit with some bubble hockey. We've taken things off ice.
Easy.
We have Henrik Zetterberg from Sweden on this side, and Pavel Datsyuk from Russia on this side. At stake is the Stanley Cup. These two will go head-to-head. Don't forget the cup is at stake, boys. Play hard!
Hey.
You want to play or you want to fight? Easy, easy.
Yes, sir!
Give me a wall!
Second period. Sweden's down 1-0.
Ah, 2-0.
Oh, what a save.
The Swedes are getting pounded.
I know. Thank you.
Oh. Well, it's the blue and white. It's Finland. Can I pull the goalie?
Does that can't count? Yeah, well, yeah. Lindstrom from red line.
Wow, a very convincing 5-0 Russian defeat. What happened out there, Mr. Zetterberg?
I don't know. Couldn't really get a hold of my players here, and Pav just outshot me too. So, no, I think he was the worthy winner today.
Well, you move on to the championship round to face Trev.
King.
Team Canada.
Team Canada.
What do you think of your chances?
My chances? Always good chances.
Nick Lidstrom and all of his Stanley Cups, Norris trophies, and impeccable defensive positioning. If it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. It's time to blow holes in this perfect human being persona.
What doesn't he do good? His car is better than mine. He probably dresses better. I don't even know what to say.
As suspected, when digging a little deeper, the mud started flinging.
I think his throwing arm is not
he's not a good thrower.
No, it's not. So that's, if anything, I will say that.
I asked him once if I could have one of his Norris trophies, but he wouldn't give it to me. So I guess you could say he's kind of selfish.
Yeah, he's not a good, very good friend, no.
He makes fun of
me. He hurts me, yeah, he hurts me. But he, you know, he doesn't know that, but he hurts my... my inner feelings when he say that to me, like a bad English.
Very insensitive.
Yeah, it's not fun to hear it every day, no.
No, I'm telling you, there's no story. I've tried everything. I can't find anything on this guy.
Hold up.
Oh my gosh. Nick Lidstrom, you just saved my life.
Ah, don't worry about it.
He
really is perfect.
That's a great.
Sorry, it's closed. Everything's closed. Sorry.
This is medium coffee.
Hold on.
No coffee for you, sir.
Where's your cup? Small chop table.
Minute sign.
Can I get a small ice cap?
Yeah.
I need to know what's
in
this for.
I can't do it.
Small ice cap.
Welcome! You have to come on the top. Oh, yes.
Are we good? Are we good? Tasha, we good?
Yeah, we're good. We're good.
Sorry, am I adding to the pressure by standing here?
A little bit. Okay. A little bit. The camera is not doing anything.
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Nick Cromwell. You're listening to Revenge Hockey here on 1270 AM, 92.1 FM, WMKT.
Boom!
There you go. Wow.
In tonight's game, this lady, every time there's a penalty to Detroit, she gets in the face of everybody. Sergei Fedorov doesn't pay attention. But last game, Brendan Shanahan had enough. Same lady on the right side. Sometimes subtlety is the best response. We haven't had Brendan back in the penalty box tonight, but we'll see what happens.
Grocery shopping together, eh, boys? Hey, first encounter of the Sasquatch, Conklin?
First one, yeah.
First one?
I'm not messing with him.
Is he scared? You're not messing with him?
No.
Is he scaring you at all?
I've seen his work.
Make me look pretty.
Yep.
Yep. My eyelashes. All right. My. Hold on.
Stop laughing.
I haven't seen a player go up like that over a goalie since Marian Gaborik and Dominik Hasek.
And his mustache stayed in perfect position the entire time.
Oh, no. Oh, he's still going. No.
This guy's everywhere.
Oh.
Look at he's still going, man. What was he doing? Holy.
Wiped out.
Now he's coming back in. That's a hazard.
That is a hazard.
That's a Justin. That
looks like you on ice.
Yes, it looks like
live from Santa Anita Park, the nation's finest three-year-olds head home in the West Coast gateway to the Kentucky Derby. Live Eastern.
Usually I talk to Nicky, I want him to shoot the puck. When I say it in English, shoot the puck, he doesn't really listen. So I go and I talk Swedish to him, then you know I'm serious.
Really, Thomas? Come on, homie. He knows I'm serious.
Yeah. Well, it's great he's wearing the mic for us tonight, so we'll bring you the sound from the ice as the game goes along here on Fox Sports.
In Swedish, he tells him to shoot the puck, and in English, he says, now, Nick, you know I'm serious.
So, you got a good playoff beard going.
No, it feels just disgusting right now.
Does it?
But you got to do what you
got
to do.
Right. Who's got the best one on the team?
Let's see. I think Chuck Norris, Draper. He got a full red, thick one going on too. So,
you guys call him Chuck Norris?
Yeah.
That's great. That's great.
So it's no shame in not getting into the lineup. How do you crack it with great guys? We call them the Black Aces, as you know. And I've watched their 3-on-3 games and all the off days and love it. And let me introduce you to all of them. This is Jamie Pusher on my far left from the Lethbridge Hurricanes, born and raised, star of Lethbridge, and he's been in the playoffs, of course, had some action. Here's a guy, he's one of the spoiled guys that went straight from junior to the NHL, Matthew Dandenault, and like Jamie, straight from Sherbrooke to the Quebec Major Junior League. Kevin Hodgson, I'm sure you know, was the most valuable player of the Sault Ste. Marie Memorial Cup in 1993 in a shutout in his first NHL game. We'll have a highlight of that. I says I get the Canadian guys on, Don, but they said, no way. Thomas is coming with us. Thomas Holstrom, who came to camp here and blew us all away and a big part of the Red Wings organization. Tim Taylor, Stratford Colton, and a great junior career in Hamilton and London. Led the American Hockey League in scoring in 94-95, or 93-94. And also Mike Knubel, who Mike Vernon says, when you get in there, don't pull it back, just shoot and... Of course, you know the story of the University of Michigan star. Thomas, give us a quick thought about coming to Detroit and how it's been for you.
It has been a really great time to be here, and you know, every place I go to is new, so it's a really good experience for me, and I like it much. So.
Great job. I know the guys love you. And I really, I mean it for grapes. We get a huge kick out of watching those three-on-three. Doing the show without Don Cherry is like playing without a goalie, Kevin. And you've had to grind it out, and they love you for it. There it is. Red Wings 1-0 after one. We'll continue on Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
Well, I think Dan Clear will be on there a lot. Pavel will be on there a lot. You know, if Holmstrom would be on there, he'd probably have to put some subtitles on there. So it's we have a few guys, but I don't think anyone really been in that situation. So there probably will be someone you don't really think about that will be on there too.
Enfield tonight, our Ram first intermission as the 1,000 game man in conversation with John Keating, who's worth many more than that. So take it away, John.
I think I've worked all of his games with the Red Wings. Was the drive to the rink any different for you tonight because you do have this milestone tonight?
Yeah, I don't know. We had lots of fun, me and Nick, driving down. Just, you know, talking different things.
You took a bow. Was that prearranged in your own head that you were going to skate onto the rink and wave to the folks here at Joe Louis Arena?
No, they've been so nice to me through the years, so I think, you know, for sure I got to do that. Yeah.
Quick thought on your team's play through the first period. How satisfied are you being 1-1?
Yeah, for sure. They had us on the heels there. They had some good chances, but we had, two crossbars or posts. So, you know, it's pretty even, but yeah, sure we can have one more.
Thanks. Congratulations. Here's to the next 1,000.
All right.
A wry smile from Thomas Holmstrom.
Giving up 4 on 15 Monday in 33 minutes. Just too many rebounds. Look at that little fella.
He doesn't want to get off. He's going for a skate down in the Red Wings zone. He's done a couple of laps. The fans are on their feet.
How cute is that?
And all the boys are giving him a tap on the rear end and way to go, kiddo.
There's your...
He's making the best of a short time of the Joe Louis ice.
He's got 15 minutes of fame as a little kid. Look at that.
That's the way to get started. Good stuff.
Hey, the Red Wings have had so many injuries, you may as well put them in.
So your days at the Joe began right here. Take me through it.
Drove in, parked in the parking lot. Mark and Dave helped me out with that. Those two guys are great guys out in the lot. They've been there a lot of years. I cruise under here. Used to love this walk. It's kind of like the game day routine. Ushers and all the people that make this rink rock and roll underneath here would be getting ready here. You see the tons of popcorn. The people that put in a lot of hard hours down here working, I'd say hi to a lot of them. I got to know quite a few of them. So say hi and then pass the alumni room. I keep coming through here and just kind of thinking about the game and who we're playing. You know, this is, I do for practice too, but mostly for games. Then because the Olympia Club, there were people there. I'm going to surprise you. I cut through the kitchen here.
Hey, bud, how you doing? Okay?
Yeah, legend right here. Yeah.
What's up, guys? Yeah. What are you guys doing?
Cut through the kitchen right here. Say hi. These guys are awesome. They put all the food out for everybody. Each and every game, this is where it all happens right here. So this is
you cut through
shortcut.
The kitchen.
I have no idea why I started to do this other than I just
kitchen.
Started to cut through the kitchen.
You mean because there was food in here, man. You ain't fooling nobody.
And there always be a ton of fans out here.
What's up?
And I'm pretty shy. There's another legend. These guys are awesome. I cruise underneath the stands, and this is where it really gets interesting.
Under the stands?
Yeah, under the stands. And I don't know why, but I just started to do this. And when you win games and you're a goalie, you don't deviate from what you're doing right. So this is one of my coming underneath here, and the same usher would be underneath here each and every time. I'd say hi to him. It was kind of a tradition, kind of a routine. But I'd have to step on each one of these right here.
Step
I couldn't
on
step
him.
Over him. Yeah, I can't step over him. You got to step on him. And once again, I'm a goalie, so I have no idea why. But it worked, and it went. So I'd have to step on each and every one of these.
Both feet?
Yeah, both feet. I'd step on them, cruise through here. Take a little longer than I expected because both flippers had to hit it. And I'd come through here. Usually I'd see the trainers in the exact same spot. For the most part, every game, they'd be here as well. So, you know, athletes, trainers are creatures of habit. And I come over here, and I take a look at the rink, kind of a, just good luck, let's work together tonight, let's have a good game, kind of just an omen. I always went through just to look at the rink, more of a tradition, more of a habit than anything. Then I head this way and open the doors and get ready for the game.
You know, one of the things I've always thought was so cool about this place was you guys won the Stanley Cups or won individual awards, and you get your name on the wall. What's it like to walk by and see your name on the wall amongst all these other legends in Redmond history?
It's an honor for sure, especially in this legendary arena. I mean, they didn't have this at first in 96, 97, even to the 2000s, all this wasn't on the wall, so it's cool coming down here. I mean, if your kids that get a chance, or if you're lucky enough to come down this legendary arena, this hallway, and see these names on the wall, that's great. These weren't here earlier, but now you're seeing names. A lot of Hall of Famers are on this wall. A lot of guys that you might not have thought won awards.
And that's one thing I noticed. Even when you walk into the dressing room, everywhere you go in this place, the tradition is preserved.
Authorized personnel only, Trev.
We're authorized.
We're authorized.
We're authorized. Go
here
for
we
it.
Go.
I'm just following you. I'm riding your coattails, guy. And when you're in this hallway going to the dressing room, the one thing I've noticed is from the time Mr. Ilitch took over till now, they've got every single team documented and some of the more famous and successful faces on the wall, including yours, right next to Scotty
Younger
and all the other guys.
There's some cool photos here. I love Bob Probert, for instance. There's some cool guys. There's Chelly right there. You have Malpe Kosher after a fight. There's some cool pictures in this hallway. I love all the old teams that you get the chance to look at back from the 80s, 82 onwards. And just love looking at the guys that you maybe have forgotten played for the Red Wings. So a lot of cool people on there. Konstantinov, again, we'll mention him. Manny Legacy, and of course Fedorov, you're the Russian Five right here on the wall, which is very, very cool. So you get a chance in the coach's office, which a place you like to be and a place you don't like to be at times, but that's where all the coaches do a lot of film work and they get the team prepared for each and every game. And this is kind of where the guys get ready. This is the stalls. And
this where was yours?
I was right here. I got a chance to sit beside Thomas Holmstrom. He sat right here. Johan Franzen sat right there, so this was a classic spot. Yeah, Holmer would help me get ready. He had a lot of things to say before each and every game, so there were some classic conversations that went on right here, but this was always fun. And then my partner, Mike Vernon, he always sat there. Jimmy Howard, who does sit there now, sat there for quite some time as well. So it's cool. And then you go out. And I always think this is one of the coolest things, too, about the rooms is Paul Boyer and his staff, they'll keep Sawchuk's stall is still up there. I mean, Ted Lindsay, I believe, is over there in the corner. I love the pictures of the guys above. You have Sawchuk. I can't believe Vernie's up there. Come on, where's my picture? Jeez. Murph's up there, cough, but you have a lot of these cool pictures that, you know, those things are great. And young players like Russo, and especially now Callahan, guys that have just got here, get to look up and see the guys that played here for the Red Wings. And who could ever forget that picture of Ted Lindsay, one of the best of all time.
That is an awesome picture.
It's just it's a great setting. It's going to be missed for sure.
I want you to take me to a place I know you really didn't enjoy
being in. It's a projection screen? Which they don't use anymore.
No, the workout room.
No, Trev, don't bring me here.
Like
come on.
To be a part of.
No. Well.
What made this place special?
Well, a lot of pain and agony at times for me. I worked out, but now these guys, when I played, it's really part of their daily routine now. Not only before the game, but afterwards, I'll come in here and do a quick 20-minute workout, you know, do maintenance. But this gym did not look like this when I played. I'll tell you that. A lot of new technology in here, and they really emphasize staying in shape and being at that top level. You see the TVs here. They'll watch the game, you know, either their game or another game. So they're always watching hockey. They're watching the league. So as they're working out, and they'll write their workouts on here, the injured guys when they're not playing.
So guys are working out. Who are these guys watching everybody do the workouts?
Those guys are some legends up there. Ted Harris looks like Paul Boyer a little bit, doesn't he?
He does.
Just a coach. But these are all the captains of all time for the Red Wings, and it's real cool you come in here. I love that they're black and white, too. It makes them look really cool. But you got anybody, Carson Cooper. I love the pictures of the older guys. It looks great, doesn't it? But then you go up Nick Lindstrom, obviously, and Steve Yzerman, in my estimation, the greatest captain for the Wings of all time. Earl Thompson's hair looking fabulous, as always. But that was one of my favorite pictures of all time.
It's
Paul
a classic.
Woods, the great radio announcer for the Red Wings. There he is right up top there.
I didn't know Woody was a captain.
Oh, yeah, he was. There he is in the corner. We forget. Our favorite of all time, Mickey Redmond, nestled in the corner here. They got to move that so you can see it easier. But there he is beside Ted Harris, who looks like Paul Boyer. But wow, Mick looks rugged there, doesn't
Mick.
He? He looks like
he's still got that stash.
He looks like a Burt Reynolds right there. But fabulously looking Burt Reynolds, but Mickey.
Burt Reynolds,
just
awesome.
Great Red Wing, great Montreal Canadian, but we love him as a Red Wing first, don't we?
So as we come into the shower area, a couple things I wanted you to point out to me. I had heard that Chris Chelios used to take that stationary bike, take it into that sauna, and pedal away even after a game. Is that true?
Yeah, he would do it on off days as well. A lot of guys still do it if they're feeling under the weather. They'll get on there, get a nice little sweat, 5-10 minutes. Not long, but a lot of guys couldn't go as long as Chris Chelios. As you can see, this is well used. It goes in the sauna, gets nice and hot in there. You get a good sweat. This thing is rusted out. You can see tons of rust all over. Not only that, there you go through like a push-up routine and sit-up routine in there as well. And it's hot in there. I've been in there with him. I'm coming in and out, and he's still doing stuff in there. So, and also there's a TV in there. You'll see there's a lot of TVs in here, and it's because there's always hockey on.
I think the lounge is more a place for guys like you and I.
Oh, for sure. And one of my favorite things in that lounge was the fridge, obviously.
What's in the fridge?
Now, this is where the lounge, where the guys relax and kind of be themselves here. Coaches don't come in here a heck of a lot. Media obviously isn't allowed in here either. But once again, you'll see the pictures of the winning teams of late 97 to 2008.
Hey, boy, Bernie.
Yeah, there's Vernie again, Conn Smythe. He played great there. Really happy. That's the shot without the cigar in his mouth that he had in most of the time after that win there. But this is the fridge. You're going to see everything from coconut water. These guys really watch what they put in their body now. Sometimes there'll be stuff what they should eat. There'll be food here, a lot of nutritious stuff. And this is just a place for the guys to be on their own, be by themselves, just some private time where they can relax and talk about whatever they want. You know, sometimes it's hockey, other times it's not. And this is where they have their lockers, and a lot of their lockers will have pictures of.
Who's got yours now?
Howie does. And this room is just awesome, and you get to come in here and kind of just relax, and maybe early in the next morning, if you play the night before, go over the game. And then
I know you want to do this.
I've done that before, and sometimes get in trouble for doing that for too long. But they get the cool table, the Wings logo, but this is just a great place. And I remember when we play here, which was funny, is all of us had kids because we had an older team. Well, this thing was with kids all the time. Thomas Holstrom's kid used to demolish this, and Chris Scopetto, who's the New Jersey Devils trainer now, drive him nuts. There'd be popcorn everywhere, wires everywhere. There'd be string tied around the couches. So this room has been used as a player's lounge and kids' time. So both things, but it's a cool place.
You continue the tour. I'll just chill right here.
Yeah, you just stick right there. Trev.
Thanks,
I'll take
pal.
Care of the rest.
I know you got this.
Oh, I do.
So where do you want to take us on our last stop on the tour?
Well, Al, everybody knows Al is, cleans the ice here, takes care of it. He's the reason why the ice is so unbelievable at the Joe Louis. We're going to stop in his office. This is also a spot when I used to play. Sometimes now, working for Fox, I'll stop by here, hang out with some of my old friends, Kirk Maltby, some guys I don't get a chance to see a lot. We'll take in some time on the couch here, but it's not about the couch. It's like, look at the stuff that's in here, though. It's unbelievable. It's kind of a cool place, and they got tons of stuff on the wall. They got the stickers, some of my artwork back when I used to play. I thought Al needed to spruce the room up just a little bit, so I thought I'd take it upon myself to do some interior decorating. Just the cool walking into the rink certain ways. I said, this place is like it's a friendly place. You know everybody's name. Mm-hmm. I don't know what I said because of Cheers, but it is like that establishment on your corner, your neighborhood, where you know everybody coming, everybody's smiling. And so it's a cool place. I'll be missed.